where does that stand right now in GA4, which is first versus last click versus trying to give each of the channels that contributed to the conversion event? Like, where is it today? How do I think about that? What should I be doing?
There's basically four different models in GA4. The most prominent that you're going to see is in the traffic acquisition report. The traffic acquisition report uses the first session, the first source of the session that drove the conversion. So what that means is, let's say I've been to the site five different times. Once I came from email, and then another time I came from paid search, and then finally I came from paid social. And on that paid social visit, I go and I convert. In that report, paid social is going to get 100% of the credit. It's the last source that drove the session before the conversion. So that's the primary method that the reports used in the traffic acquisition report. So we can get into the nuance. There's a lot of nuance which actually causes a lot of issues with how comparing to universal and how that tracks and all that stuff. But just know that that's primarily the last source that drove it.
Okay.
The other attribution models are ways to look at attribution are the first user source, which is another report called the user acquisition report. That is showing you kind of your top, the first channel or source that drove the user, regardless of how many more times they come to the site. So the first time I come to your site is paid social. I will always fall into paid social in that report because it's just showing you what channel acquired the user at the user level. So that's another report kind of acquisition or attribution piece. The other part is data-driven attribution. And Google kind of made a big stink about data-driven attribution because, you know, it basically looks at all the touch points that led to a conversion. So in my first example, if I came from email and paid search and paid social over a given amount of time, all of those channels will get some amount of credit in the data-driven model. And so maybe, you know, paid social will get like 60% because that actually closed me. It was the last channel I used. Maybe, you know, paid email will get, I don't know, 15% because that was kind of what introduced me. It was whatever we don't know how they do that. It's all kind of machine learning type stuff, right? But that's the data-driven model, is trying to give partial credit to different channels depending on how they contributed to the conversion. So that one is, I think is great, right? It's a great way to attribute conversions and give credit to different channels. However, it really doesn't show up in the reports. It only shows up when you go to the advertising section and then go to the attribution comparison report. It's the only place you can see it, really. And so that becomes very problematic because it just doesn't show up in many other places. So I tend to focus more on the traffic acquisition report. It's not similar to Universal Analytics in how it actually tracks, but it's the most similar in how it's trying to track.